I hear many people say Glass Onion has characters that are too simple and bland for it to really stand out, but I disagree. The movie itself doesn't give you any character expositions or motivations. It makes you do it by getting in your head. Take, for example, the beginning of the film. There's really not much backstory or exposition for the characters, and because they're simple, we often see them in other films and real life. And just like real life, we place our own biases and motives towards these characters, and that's where the movie hooks you in. It hooks you in by making you ask why these characters are doing what they're doing, and it allows you to ask these questions by not giving you exposition. And without exposition, your brain tries to fill in the gaps. Rian Johnson makes you question the characters, answer the questions yourself, and watch to know if your observations are correct. And that's how he hooks you in. But okay, this seems like lazy writing. But is it? With your own motives placed on these characters, the movie can now really start tricking you. Duke seems like an insecure asshole, and his girlfriend just seems like a socialite looking to climb the ranks. And the movie agrees. That's what they are, and it even shows it to you. But there's just something off about how the movie confirms your biases. When it's this easy to figure out a movie, subconsciously, we become guarded and start asking even more questions in our head. Not to mention the obviousness of how evil-looking Miles is when he's first introduced. But having too many unanswered questions becomes boring, as it can often feel like the story is going nowhere. So being as sneaky as Rian Johnson is, he literally tells you the answers through Blanc.
To destroy Andy and shield Miles Braun, we need to find out why. Motive.
Well, that's it, right? That's the movie. Our questions are answered, the motives are confirmed, and the ending should be smooth sailing. But wait, didn't Miles seem off from the start of the film? Is he really not the bad guy? Just when you think you got somewhere, and you were smart enough to figure it all out, Rian pulls the rug out from under you. What seemed like a scene that answers all your questions leaves you asking more. Before you can even start figuring out what really is happening, the pacing increases and the real mystery starts. But there's a catch. Before you even get to realize what is happening, before you remember that Miles looked shady from the start, the movie reveals the villain. And what do you know? You were right from the start, but it's too late. Rian led you on a wild goose chase and you finally forgot about the main villain, even though you explicitly knew it would be Miles. Finally, we have all the answers and the movie is done. But wait, the movie is not finished and it leaves you with the greatest question of them all. How will this all end? And my God, as soon as you ask that question in your head, Helen shows up with the answer. But is it really the answer? No. No, it's not. Up until the very last second of the film, there's no real answer. The characters are meant to be blank canvases for us to paint and give motives that we think they might have, only for the film to lead us on, confirm our biases, and then rip it all away. Glass Onion was a perfect movie in misdirection and subtle storytelling. It absolutely has no need for exposition or backstories for these characters, as we simply fill in the rest.